And now, a message from the Goshen High School English Department.
Hey Goshen High School, Mrs. Baker here. I bring you this video today in reflection and in thanks. Over the past couple of months, perhaps a few weeks, we're all home on remote learning, learning anew. But being on a Google Meet with you is just not the same as being in the classroom. We miss you incredibly. When the teachers are on their Google Meets, we're discussing everything that has been happening, and we all agree on one thing. You, your ability to stay strong and to adapt to change. Thank you. Thank you for your post responses, your Flipgrid presentations, for your Google Meets. Thank you, Goshen High School. So hey, we thought, why not give back? I mean, after all, for years we've asked you to write long essays, to present in the classroom, and it's time. It's time now for us to create and give back to you. So Goshen High School, sit back and enjoy a few poems created by some of your teachers that reflect upon our time away. And until we meet again, stay strong, stay healthy, stay well. We miss you, Goshen High School.
Now, one thing I think a lot of people are just so scared of any recipe they see that says sugar, syrup, or caramel, that they're, no, I won't do anything like that.
Hey everyone, Miss J here. I'm not much of a cook myself, but I have to say I have this one recipe that I feel that is really essential that everyone practices. It serves literally everyone, and you only need three ingredients: letters, words, and a pinch of emotion. It's called The Perfect Recipe for Communication by Miss Yunchai. Letters. When placed together, they bind to form sound. Minced side by side, intentions abound to evoke the garnish of expression. Sh, ha, lol, ah, ugh, k, blah. But expressions alone are mere appearance, serving as statements or impressions without clearance. Something is still lacking, slacking, and so nerve-wracking. Something vital for coherence. Words. When needed together, they possess the capability to digress, mend, staple, and unite those divergent hearts, keeping us together or forever and ever apart. Yes, no, whatever, all right, sure. But words alone are a mere choice of diction, serving as time fillers or painkillers with demolition, or the blueprint of a pillar left unsaid. Something is still lacking, slacking, and so nerve-wracking. Something vital needs to be spread. Emotion. When mixed together, a human is there. A seed of emotion is planted somewhere. The al dente, undefinable, universal language. If you're sorry, then say you care. Explain your thoughts and why they're there. Letters, words, and a pinch of emotion, caramelized well, forms the perfect potion. The recipe for communication is simple, you see. It just takes the addition of you and me.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. And be one traveler long I stood, and look down one as far as I could.
Here I am on a forest walk, nothing to hear, no one to talk. My pleasant stroll is ruined by this. What, you ask, is amiss? I'm faced with a fork, like Robert Frost. Decisions, decisions, at what cost? If I go this way, what will I find? I'll take a step. No, I change my mind. I peer down each road, trying to see what each path holds for me. I'm faced with a fork, like Robert Frost. Decisions, decisions, at what cost? College, career, which way to go? How to choose, how to know? What if an obstacle is just down the way? Well, that would really ruin my day. I'm faced with a fork like Robert Frost. Decisions, decisions, at what cost? The difficulty is in the choice. I must get in touch with my inner voice. As Emily Dickinson likes to say, to dwell on possibility is the way. Each of these roads has twists and turns. Each offers a chance to grow and learn. Decisions aren't something to face with fear. Once you start, the way becomes clear. So take that first step and follow your heart. I wish you luck. It's time to start.
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids, who can understand anything they say? Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers. While we're on the subject, kids, you can talk.
This generation is doomed, they say. Quick to buy hearsay, even quicker to betray. It doesn't share, it doesn't care, and perhaps most critically, it's filled with hot air. No dreams, no goals, pyramid schemes, lack of control, favorites and retweets, they drive the bus, and they can't communicate, they can't discuss, but hold up. Maybe, just maybe, they're wrong, like they've been before. You know they killed Socrates for asking his students to think? They said the internet would bring us to the brink of extinction. They said television was a critical thought jail, and they said Gutenberg's press would make young minds stale. Sometimes the others are just too colorblind to really see the truth, to really feel the vibe, to really understand the youth. Hell, look at all these colors that fill the aluminum seats. Fluorescent blue biologist, neon green philosopher, fire engine red rider, and tie-dye purple painter. Look at the uplifting smiles, the trendy styles. Look at the thinkers stewing, the intelligence brewing. Look at the gears grinding, the hearts binding, compassion radiating, souls figure skating. This generation, there's magic in your bones, an iridescent grit, and we're your biggest fans, and this is your biggest hit. So continue to let your light shine, not just for you, but for others on their quest, all the while ignoring the rest, because you are leaders, and quite frankly, we continue to be impressed. This generation doomed? No, it's not what it seems. This generation has bloomed a beautiful blend of Technicolor dreams.
And now for something completely different.
News brief. Education, information, regulation, sterilization, trepidation, mobilization, medication, intubation, unification, isolation, starvation, stratification, population, desolation, duration, mitigation, stimulation, quotation, polarization, immigration, dedication, innovation, reformation, collaboration, donation, segregation, revocation, altercation, frustration, mutation, abdication, graduation, meditation, recreation, dissertation, litigation, vaccination, Corona Nation, change the station.
They say being the new girl is tough. I say bring it on. New district, third year in a row, so what? A new group of people, a new group of students, no problem. A third year planning an entire curriculum, I could do that. Coach a couple sports, teach groups of 30 at a time, yeah, I'll figure it out. Set my alarm for 4 a.m., commute an hour each way, I'm fine, I'll just drink some coffee. Packing 4 bags a day, 2 for work, 1 for coaching, 1 for the gym, I'll just do it the night before. Remembering who teaches science on the third floor, hold on, can I describe to you what she looks like? Names aren't my thing, especially not in a district this big. But wait, what do you mean I have four Alexes in the same class? Coach soccer in the fall? I'd love to. Coach Harris needs help with basketball? Sure, but you do know I can't make a layup, right? You said on your resume you played lacrosse. A national championship? That's impressive. Well, actually, it's a funny story. Never mind that. You're going to be great. Remember when I said 4 a.m.? How is it dark when I leave and when I get home? And remember those bags I packed? Well, the third one fell off on the side of 84. And you don't know how many times I've heard, Miss M, I think I forgot a pencil, take one off my desk. But I think I also forgot my book, here, take mine. But Miss M, one more thing, can I sit at your desk? Oh, and the snacks? Yeah, they're gone too. Miss M, I thought you didn't like chocolate. I don't, but I know that you guys do. So yeah, I guess sometimes it is a little tough. But you know what's not? Working in a place where everyone knows my name. Morning commute, the best one I have is from spot 22 to my room. Students anxiously waiting to hold the door for you. You're 20 yards away? No problem. They've still got you. Small waves and little hellos from tired faces that think they'd rather be anywhere else. But little do they know. Yeah, I miss it. But you know what I miss too? Battling Mr. Quinlan through the wall to see whose speaker system is louder. Having Tony toss me his radio saying, these halls are yours now. Or maybe it's Mr. Harris telling me I could literally hear you from a mile away with those shoes on. It's definitely not fighting with the coffee machine before I've even had a sip of coffee. But then it just might be seeing the fountain of post-it notes plastered all over my desk before I can even put any of those bags down. Some are just simple smiley faces or cute little hearts, and some say things like Jacob was here, but the Jacob was crossed out, and now it says Peyton and Jacob were here. These notes that I'm talking about, they're stuck to birthday cards and Christmas gifts that I just can't quite take off my desk. People will say, you do know it's May, right? But things like that, they don't come with an expiration date. And their laughs and smiles, it's probably about the sweetest music you've ever heard in your life. You're having a bad day? Take a trip down these halls. These laughs and smiles will make your day. Wait, no, your week. Well, if we're getting technical, they've made my entire year. So yeah, I guess they can say being the new girl is tough. But I don't see it.
Romeo, Romeo, Romeo and Juliet. Juliet,
Juliet time.
Romeo, yeah. Romeo, Romeo and Juliet, Juliet.
Well, did you ever hear of the story of Romeo and Juliet? A boy meets a girl, they rock each other's world, and it seems like their lives are set. Ah, but fate steps in and messes things up, and yo, it all ends in regret. They had life on
with a respectful bow and apology to Mr. William Shakespeare. To meet or not to meet? That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the threats and panic of pandemic peril, or to take up quarantine against the sea of germs and, by masking, evade them. To separate, to safeguard, no more. And by closing the doors of Goshen High to say we end the exposure, the heartache, and the thousand forms of infecting that human contact is heir to. 'Tis a comfort devoutly to be wished. To sleep, to turn off the morning alarm, to sleep. Perchance to be bored senseless. Aye, there's the rub. For in that quarantine, what deprivations may come when we have shuffled off this social community must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of social distancing and masking. For who would bear the whips and scorns of academia, the endless assignments, tests, and cafeteria noise, the daily drone of school bells, the expense of senior prom, the interminable speeches under a hot sun at graduation, when they might a peaceful vacation take with a Cuomo-sanctioned quarantine? Who would grunt and sweat in overheated hallways, but that the dread of endless family jigsaw puzzles, recurring TV dramas, daily baking, and toilet paper rationing puzzles the pandemic plight and makes us rather bear those ills we have than fly to those we know not of? Thus, love of human company makes COVID-19 cowards of us all, and the safety of our students, classmates, custodians, and school staff rises above personal privations, and enterprises of great pith and moment, with this regard, turn to creative alternatives for celebrating the stellar graduating class of 2020. Students who rose to a world challenge, forging new trails to escape the belly of boredom, cherishing that which was taken before tasted.
Deafening silence. It's the sounds I'm missing. The distant chatter in the cafe, the joyful laughter in the classroom, the pattering of feet in the hallway, from softest whisperings to thunderous cheers. It's the sounds I'm missing. The crackling of morning announcements, the buzzing of my neighbor's speakers, the crunching of feet running above to win the race, I'm sure. I want to hear Goshen sing. From jingling bells to howling students to hushing teachers. From athletes swooshing, soaring, and zipping. To musicians harmonizing, whistling, and singing. Clinking, chiming, booming. Delightful and delicious. It's the sounds I'm missing.